I'm not a political scientist, and my specialist is not necessary institutions as such, but I was very tempted to looking at the institutional conditions, because inclusive development or growth cannot be thought without looking at institutional conditions. So I have a quite detailed PowerPoint prepared, so I will skip, of course, with matter, you know, for the sake of time. I just wanted to say this is an exciting time to do research in Africa. A lot of things, new things happening, new players coming, and the FDI investment finally taking place in Africa. But still, structural transformation, despite Eric said there is a sign, big structural transformation is not yet taking place. Okay? And as we all know that there was initially very high endemic poverty and high inequalities at independence, but since independence, 50 years, if you look at it, that growth patterns cannot be said for the poor. Actually, it has been sort of against the poor over 50 years, and it is, of course, growth was not good. And but I emphasize that there wasn't any proper conduit and the channels from which growth, even if there, translated into broad-based development. So pattern of economic growth was not necessarily inclusive at all and shared growth. And yet we know that the rates, both rates of growth and the pattern of growth are very much influenced by institutional environment. And when we talk about institutions, it is very important critically. Economists talk institution in terms of, you know, what sort of institution are growth enhancing and efficiency gains, but it is very important institutional conditions for distributional outcomes. So I try in these papers to see at broad, very broad brushed presentation, but try to see what sort of foundation are necessary to think about institutions which are inclusive. I have another paper which looked at growth distribution nexus, but in this paper, I mean, shared growth or inclusive growth could be approached from two angles. One is how to share growth. So gains from growth is shared, exposed through some sort of mechanism, often retrospective fiscal tax come subsidy, transfer mechanism policies for redistribution. That is literature, growth with redistribution. How to do it with pie created, how to redistribute. I take in this paper much more broader definition, or broader in the sense my paper is not inclusive growth as in the conference, but inclusive development, because I think it's a development process which are important, and the shared growth is interpreted inclusive process of growth with sharing opportunities exante, all encompassing inclusive of the poor. So how to create that sort of development process is something exante process. That is what I try to engage it. And looking it in this paper, especially from the angle of institution, what sort of institutional transformation is required to address root cause of inequality, which prevent making broad-based development from taking place in sub-Saharan Africa. And objectives, therefore, it is explore the path. And for that, I mean, we can talk institutions very broadly without analytical framework, but I found this endogenous institutional changes by Greif and Aoki, both at Stanford universities, that proposing comparative institutional analysis, which are You know, building from North, Douglas North and all other institutional economists, looking at more institutional organization diversity. And I found that is a very, very interesting framework, and I want to share with you. My paper, as Eric did, I first put it, what is paper about? And outline is, of course, first analytical paper, how I try to understand institution configuration. And importantly, I try to see as a system for development, particularly dynamic interface institutions are interpreted as rule of the game and player of the game, which are organizations, not only individuals. So dynamic interface organizations, institutions, rule of the game. And then specifically looking at the analytical framework institutions and how to understand that relationship, inclusive development, distributional issues. And then I introduce endogenous institutions and institutional changes, which are, for me, very important concept to build analysis. And then section three is a very broad brush, what happened in Africa, looking at from this institutional configuration system, the domestic institutional environment, and then interface international domestic conditions, particularly reform era, why they couldn't really create institutions as such which are workable, endogenously institutions, and then what is a new millennium, what is a new conditions, and I try to provide concluding remarks. Institutions, we know generally, I don't want to discuss a lot, but from an economics point, there are a lot in gross literatures, Roderick, Semolblu, and every mainstream gross literature, which talk about, you know, institution and gross relationship. But when it comes to more nitty-gritty of what are the institutions, there are new institutionalism and old institutionalism, and there are distinct differences. But today, I'm looking at the more new institutional perspective. I have another paper writing from a more structural view of it. But today, I try to look at this analytical framework. And Norse's definition is well known. What is this institution? Humanly devised constraint through incentive and sanctions, shaping human transactions, exchanges, and the structure opportunities. So that's broad one. But importantly, that consists of formal rules, which are constitutional property right rules and contracts, and informal one, which are social norms and customs mindset. This all have to come together to create institutional environment. And then Aoki build on it and talk about institutional configuration as a system. It's complex and diverse, and it's formal, informal. And it creates multiple equilibrium. And that was very interesting for me to go through that, how equilibrium shift from one to another. And the graph also looks similarly, but looking at regularity of social behavior, social rules, to guide and motivate individuals. But I thought, importantly, looking at individuals are not only just individuals versus state, but they act, interact as organization, member of different organizations, associations. So we have to look at dynamics, institutions, and organizations. They are different, particularly institution, organization. Institutions create framework, but collective action takes place within organizations and bounded by common purpose. So organization has a particular way of placing, defining it. And institution, if we looked at institution as a general rules of the game, organizations are players of the game who can act as agent of institutional change. And that's important because associations and organizations are important player, agent for change. So dynamic interplays, organization, unit of channels, and again within organizations they create different rules at different levels. And rules is set through collective actions and political process. And there is hierarchical order of two perspectives that rules is exogenous predetermined outside the domain of economic transactions, legal and social norms, rules of the game, and economic institutions like contracts, market, organizations, they are hybrid, rational transaction cost-saving response within this constraint rules. So I look at the system of institutional configurations from this point of view. So basically, Coase and Williamson's transaction cost economics is looking at functional role of organizations for efficient contracts and minimizing transaction cost. So I tried understanding this relationship between transaction cost perspective and rule of the game perspective. But within neo-institutionalism, they all take very functional view on the role of institutions. And as I said, for inclusive development, it's important to look at the distributional outcome, how determined by institutions, as opposed to structural view taken by old evolutionary institutionalism. As I said, Aoki and Greif use equilibrium analysis and agency theory as strategic game theories, and looking at particularly this perspective, and they emphasize organizational, institutional diversity as a system for development outcomes, also efficiency and distribution. And here, Aoki, Hayami, Greif, Aoki, lots try to combine new and old institutional approaches together. And when it comes to specifically institutions and that relationship, inclusive development, there are literature on this. One which came out earlier is by Samuel Bowles and other his colleagues, looking at why institutional configuration, institutional environment can create poverty traps. And they define institutional poverty traps takes place when institutions that implement unequal division of the social product, so there are distributional outcome from that institutional configuration is very unequal, but at the same time, if they cannot provide efficiency gains, then they fail both sides, and the poor cannot have a voice in this creating different institutional environment because they don't have coordination abilities for collective action to tip from unequal to more equal set of institutions. So that is institutional poverty traps, which I initially started looking at this relationship institution and inclusive development. And then it comes, as Eric mentioned, this Acemoglu Robinson, looking at two contrasting set of institutional characters, inclusive and extractive one, and economic and political ones. Economic institution, inclusive ones, enforce property rights, create level playing field, and encourage investment in new technology skills, versus extractive ones, structure to extract resources from the many by the few. That's an economic, inclusive, extractive one. Political institution, inclusive one, is distributing political power in a pluralistic manner with some political centralization versus extractive one, which concentrate power in the hand of very few. And they try to provide narratives looking at the powerful synergy between economic political institutions and try to see how this institutional environment change dynamics of distribution and efficiency. And they say virtuous versus vicious circle created. Extractive institutions sometimes spur the growth, but they cannot sustain, but they cannot encourage innovations. And the institution always constantly drift around, but the major institutional change taking place at critical junctures when exogenous things are happening. And so when I looked at this, their books about, you know, this, their definition, narratives, joint determination, economic, political institutions, superiority, inclusive over extractive, that's not much disagreement on that. We all want inclusive political economic institutions. But the real challenge remains when we try to think about how to create institutional foundations. Then this accepting desirable general home institutions and formal establishment by itself does not build, because as you remember, institutions is configuration, formal and informal one. And inclusive institutions, I mean, they should be underpinned by shared belief and norms. And the inclusive institution may be achieved through different traditional paths. And that's where Aoki Greif's and Hayami's comparative institutional analysis, which are very much looking into diversity, is very important. This inclusive institution per se, do not necessarily lead to more equitable distributional outcome economic policy making. They are necessary but not a sufficient condition, I think. And settled arrangement, institutional arrangement that dictated and determined by political power relationship and the conflict resolution mechanisms. And, you know, US, British, all these inclusive institutions cannot be created without that struggle. So institution development is not a simple convergence towards our emulation best practice somewhere else, but it had to be endogenously created. So what is endogenously created institutions should be endogenously developed in a specific local context, so African context, which should be viable, sustainable, and formal institutions which simply supplanted from outside without careful adaptation cannot work. And interdynamics between institutions and the organization are very critical forces for social change, and socially, politically sustainable development in both institutional innovations and for local settings. So comparative analysis institutions, very important. Endogenous institutions is self-enforcing, self-sustained system of shared belief. And from that point, when it comes to my sub-Saharan Africa stories, which I will be very quickly go, it's very important to understand what is government and the endogenous institutions, what is government and the state. Government is organization as defined in Aoki, play of the game in this political domain, whereas state is a stable order of relationship between the government and the private agent. And that changes from one stable equilibrium to another ones, depending on this interplay dynamics, organizations and institutions. And market development will force create nation state, and the third party mechanism are necessary. And this public-private relationship are very important, therefore, institution development nexus. and three prototypes of the state. Democratic and democratic state can be also different shade of, you know, social democrat, federal system, pluralist bureau ones, developmental state, all kind of democratic state. Also, there are collusive relationship between state and private agents, which is, you know, particularly state government uses particular group of private sector as collusive reasons, and predatory. And the story which I wanted to build, which I cannot go through with time limit, is basically early years in Africa, they try to have developmental visions. They inherited very much extractive political economic institutions as Morgan Robinson, but huge gap between leaders' high visions and institutions' configurations, and state-centered development without having impersonal state institutions continuously accommodating extractive political economic institutions, and they didn't have proper tax and public goods provision, proper interface between private and public relationships. So this negative public-private interfaces created early years, very not conducive to inclusive one. When it comes to reform period, fiscal retrenchment, poor under-provision of public goods, and government engaged more with donor community, which pushed policy conditionality, their own and donor-crafted policies. It was not endogenized, and therefore it didn't create any endogenous institutional change from the early years. So formally, even if they create democratic state, it didn't have substance and proper private-public interface. Now, Africa changing, I'm finishing. Africa changing, I will go to concluding remarks. That basically, there were institutional traps that has kept poor from benefiting from growth in Africa. It's a sweeping generalization I made. Of course, I know Africa is heterogeneous, but I just make it narrative. And shift from this low institutional equilibrium to new one is very important. But importantly, looking at self, creating self-sustained system of shared belief, informal in the sense social norms, and it had to build what is there in Africa. It cannot be supplanted from outside. And functional coalitions through better fiscal dialogue. I mean, Africa, lot of resource-rich economies, they didn't need to broaden tax base because they had the natural resource rent. And so they didn't really converse with the private agent as such. And they didn't have a provision of public goods. So private-public relationship was very unproductive. That had to be changed. And functional coalitions is very important. Broadening tax net in return for improved public service and sustained public goods so that informal, fragile informal activities can be mainstreamed and broader engagement in official economies away fragility of informal economy and negotiate better deals. Globalization is a critical juncture. It creates opportunities, but very much challenges. Globalization needs strong nation state, and for that you need functional, strong coalition, and building pro-developmental institutions are necessary, and aid community is just a handmaiden for participating this creating institution, local institution configuration. They cannot be driver. That is the story I just quickly wanted to say thank you.